Hi guys, here in this video we're going to talk about how to create the connection between PrestaShop and Odoo. So first of all, we're going to the commerce integration module, we're clicking on new button and starting creating cell integration. We need to set up name for cell integration and select a commerce system, in my case it's PrestaShop. Click on save and now we're running quick configuration wizard. On the first step we need to set up URLs and web service keys. URLs I can simply take from my shop, admin URL and shop URL. And regarding web service key, we can take it from the advanced parameters web service. We need to click on add new web service key. We need to activate all the necessary permissions, set the description name. I already done it, so let's check. Don't forget to activate enable PrestaShop web service checkbox. Let's check my, I can simply copy the value. As you can see, all the permissions are activated and we're going back to our Odoo. Click on next. In the second step, we're checking that all permissions are activated on the PrestaShop site. If everything is okay, all the required lines will be green. Let's go next. Here we're checking what languages we are receiving from the PrestaShop site, and we can see them in this list. In my case, it's only one language, but if I need to activate some languages on the Odoo side, I can click on go to languages, activate it, and they will appear here. So also I need to activate to set integration language and shop language. On the fourth step, we need to configure default taxes for different tax rules. As we know, the structure of taxes is different between PrestaShop and Odoo. In Odoo we have taxes and in PrestaShop we have tax rules, and some tax rules can have multiple taxes. So for the correct export and import of products, we need to set up default taxes for each lines. So let's do it. Each tax line we set up default tax. Let's go to the next step. Here we need to define in what statuses we are planning to receive orders from PrestaShop into Odoo. We can choose some of them, for example, to receive only shipped and delivered, but if it's necessary, you can activate all of them. Also, here we have ability to trigger status change from Odoo to PrestaShop if I am doing some status changes in the Odoo side. For example, if I'm planning to cancel order in Odoo, and then I can specify what status I want to send into PrestaShop. I'm canceling in Odoo, and then canceled status will be sent into PrestaShop. This is how it works, but you can specify it later. Let's go to the next step. And the last one is start initial import. I activate the checkbox, clicking on finish, and the system will redirect me to the job queue menu. Here we can see that we are starting import of different objects from PrestaShop into Odoo, and when all of them will go to the done status, they will appear in the mapping table. But regarding initial import, we will talk in a future videos. Thank you.